Howdy there. For those of you who don't know, my name's Fiendish and I'm a Minecrafter slash YouTuber. Today I'd just like to show you the project that I've been working on, which is this 7-segment display counter. Basically the way it works is you've got the zero, that's obviously the display module, then you know, press the button, counts up one, and continues up to 9 and then has a little reset period. And it has a few hiccups, like for 4 you can see that it goes to 0 then goes to 4. As well as 8, takes a very long time to finish, but that's because it's version 1, it's unoptimized and it definitely needs some revamping. So hopefully I'll be bringing out another video, so if you want to keep up to date, you can definitely click subscribe so that when that new video comes out you can see it. I also do other videos throughout the week, generally one a day if I can find time for it, and then that's it. Reset. Excuse me. And when it's day, which will be very soon, I am going to give a little tour of the inner workings. Okay, so we've got some light now, and this is the 7-segment display module here. This is basically all this jumble of stuff is basically just isolating the 7 segments of 3 torches each. So they link up. And so basically this controls all of one segment. This is the middle segment, because you can see it's turned off. And these ones are all turned on, which is the outer rim, because it's a zero. And this, each bar represents a number, as in this bar, and this bar. And the way it works is these are the logic gates that tell which number can come on. So this is getting power, so this turns off. So these torches turn on the segments for zero, representing this number. And then if this logic gate, the logic gate for one, was to be on, or to, you know, be approved, then these would turn on, which are the right-hand side ones being making a one. And then this is just a repeater to, you know, so we have enough length to fit everything in. And we'll get to the logic gates in a second. These are the toggle flip-flops, the 4-bit toggle flip-flop set. So there's 4 of them, and they basically make a 4-bit counter. And every time I press the button, it counts up 1 in binary. So it starts off at 0000, which is what we're on, and then when I press the button, it becomes 0001, and then 0010, and basically, first toggle flip-flop, this is the output, you can see it's off. Second toggle flip-flop here, and you can see it's on, 0010, this is the second part. And then this is the output for the third flip-flop, and this is the output for the fourth flip-flop. And so at the moment we have a 3. So if we just come around this way, it's a very big, unoptimized maze at the moment. This bit's, I don't know how I got this, it's just I was trying to do it as I went along. So we're actually on 2, not 3, apologies. 0010, yes, that's 2. And so if we just come up here and try not to fall off, as I've done so many times, this is literally the logic gate. It basically consists of this OR gate, this is a giant OR gate really, and then 3 repeaters and an inverter, and this is basically 0010. So you can see this is on, this is off, this is off, and this is off. So this is the second flip-flop that's literally coming from there, and it finds its way up to here. And that's the same for all of them, except not all of them are repeaters. Some will be inverters, such as this one, whichever needs to be turned on. Because if you can imagine, say that this was off. That didn't work. Apologies, I'm not even sure why. That should really be turning on. I don't know why it isn't. That is a glitch, I'd say. See if we did it this way. And there we go. Yeah, I do deeply apologize for that. I'm not sure what was going on. It should have acted like that in the first place, but it didn't. So this this is the OR gate. So if well, it's actually a NOR gate. So because just one of these are on, this can't turn on. At the moment, nothing will be displayed. But when we reconnect this up, then this is allowed on, and now we have a 2 on the board. And so basically, that's the same for each one, except it's a different gate. Like there'll be some will be inverters, some will be repeaters. There is a few AND gates because it's easier. But generally, it's all quite similar. And a part of this, especially not how to wire that up, but that idea with the numbers and the bars, I've just been browsing and looking around, and that's what I found. But most of it, especially this toggle flip-flop system and the logic gates, were basically original ideas, but I don't take credit for that because I'm sure you've seen that plenty of times before, and I'm pretty sure this is the way most people do it anyway, but I worked that bit out for myself. And well, that's basically it for this version, and I'd like to most certainly make another version, so yeah, stay subscribed, or subscribe if you want, to see that, as well as the daily videos that I bring out, which basically one of these is. And that's basically it. As an inside joke to a very select few people who will get it, I'd like to say a shout out to the awesomeness of Jara and PJ, because they'll enjoy that. And ow, that hurt. Not really, because I'm on peaceful. Imagine trying to build this in the night with monsters, and they're blowing you up all your systems. But this took a lot of fiddling, and then I finally kind of got it, and then it kind of works. And yeah, so thanks for watching. Please rate if you like it or you think it's, you know, it's got potential. Obviously, it doesn't have practical potential. I do realize that this is completely impractical. I mean, why would you want this? Just a counter that takes up this much space. But I mean, it's just, you know, fun with Redstone, doing something with my time, very inappropriate, but you know, I do stuff sometimes, just generally I play Minecraft. So yeah, once again, thank you for watching. Don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.